Hi, we have seen that we can distinguish different types of convection. We have already seen free convection and forced convection. Well, I want to focus a little bit on forced convection today, and I consider a tube with a certain diameter d. And a fluid is flowing through this tube. Let's say a certain volume flow rate is entering and leaving this tube. This is the wall. So now you see it in front of you. And the question I pose here, how does the heat transfer coefficient depend on the diameter? Well, you would say that's quite easy. You calculate the Nusselt number and you know it. Well, that's true. But the first question I pose myself is, do I have here a turbulent or a laminar flow? Because in case of a turbulent flow, we know correlations to calculate the Nusselt number. So in case we have a highly turbulent flow, which means that all the fluids is mixed, and we want to calculate a heat transfer coefficient, that means there's a temperature difference between wall and fluid, then we take a well-known equation of 0.027 multiplied by Reynolds to the power 0.8 multiplied by Prandtl to the 0.13. Well, we assume that the volume flow rate is constant. So that means that the Reynolds number, which is defined by a velocity multiplied by a diameter multiplied by a kinematic viscosity, we have to rewrite them into a volume flow rate, which can be done by multiplying both sides by a quart p day multiplied. And if you do this, you see here, I apologize, should be quart PD also below, then we see that this is equal to, well, this is the volume flow rate. This is defined by 4, P is here, multiplied by 4, 5 V, multiplied, divided by P, kinematic viscosity and the diameter. So we see that Reynolds is proportional to d to the minus 1 if V volume flow rate is constant. That means that if we now look at the Nusselt number here, we see that we have here a Reynolds number to the power 0.8, so that means that the heat transfer coefficient, which is h over d divided by lambda, is proportional to d to the point, well, 0.8 minus, so minus 0.8, so excuse me, yeah. Then we have to divide by the diameter, so the heat transfer coefficient is proportional to the diameter to the power minus 1.8. But this all fixed for the case if we have turbulent flow. What happens if we have laminar flow? Well, in laminar flow, we have seen that something completely different is dealing. First of all, in laminar flow, if we flow again with a constant volume flow rate, then we see that first of all, it takes some time before we have a steady state situation. So after a certain entrance length, Xe, we have a constant temperature profile. And in that case, the Nusselt number for laminar flow, and I take the index L, is 3.66, just a constant. Well, this Nusselt number is also equal to h over d multiplied by lambda. So here you see that the heat transfer coefficient is equal to lambda multiplied by Nusselt divided by diameter. Nusselt is constant, lambda is constant, so this is proportional to d to the 1 minus 1. So what we have learned here, that there is quite a large difference at a constant volume flow rate between the laminar situation, in this case HL, and the turbulent situation. So remember always, pose yourself the question, what's constant in this question? In this case, we took the volume flow rate constant, but in another case, we could say we take the velocity constant and calculate then what's happening. Thanks for your attention.